Shalom and welcome. I'm so glad you could join today, and I just want to share something with you. That is, I get a comment a lot, and sometimes it's a question, but it's the same theme. And one of our members, he told me that a friend of his gave him the same comment. So obviously this is a question that's in a lot of people's hearts, and that's, should I trust Adonai, or should I trust a website or some of my efforts to do or get a relationship partner? And that's a bit of a odd question, but I noticed that is what beginners usually ask, or they struggle with that. Now, me, when I was still single, that was one of the questions that I struggled with. But now looking back, it looks a bit strange. I can't think how I could think that way. But anyway, for people that still think that way, maybe it will help you. If somebody told me what I know now, back then, it would have saved me a lot of times of frustration and struggle, because you sign up on a website and then you think, no, but I'm not trusting the Lord, I should trust him, and then you close your account, and then you struggle so much, and then you think, maybe I heard him wrong, I have to go try a website again. And then for 2-3 weeks, you don't actually do something because you are double-minded, and but it's there. And then you close it again, and so there's no solid direction that you go on. So I trust this will clear up some things for you. So what do you say when a person say you should trust the Creator and not a website? Trust Adonai. Don't try and trust the website. Now, I never say trust the website. I would say trust Adonai anyway. So whether you use a website or not, trust him. Now, what I mean with that is, you won't go outside in the snow and say, no, I'll trust Adonai that I'll survive, and then don't put on warm clothes. So, for example, there was this Messianic guy, and he was in a flood, in a city, a big flood, and there comes a guy on a stump, big stump, that float down as the water runs down. And he said, come to me, let's go to safety, at least because the water is rising, come and let's get out of here. So he said, no, I'm trusting Adonai, I'm gonna stay here, he's gonna save me. So later, there comes a guy in a motor boat, he's looking for people that he can help and take them to safety. So he comes there and he tells the guy, but come, let's go to safety. And he said, no, I'm trusting Adonai, I'm not going to do anything, I'm just going to wait here and he's going to save me. So later on, the water is so high, and he's on the rooftop, and he's up to his knees in water. And then a helicopter comes past, a rescue helicopter, and they are looking for people. And he said, no, I'm trusting Adonai, I'll wait, he's going to save me. So he died because he's been exposed to the cold too long. And then when he comes to the pearly gates, he met Peter, and he said, now Peter, why didn't you guys come save me? He said, now didn't you see the stump and the motorboat and the helicopter? So 3 times we tried to save you, but you didn't get in. So maybe the website is just a stump coming by. Maybe it's a motorboat, or maybe it's a helicopter, your last chance. Now, what I've noticed a lot of times, it doesn't matter if you go on the stump or the motorboat or the helicopter, but just do get on and make progress. Now, sometimes People will say they don't like doing a dating site because people on there are usually bad or negative or something like that, and scams. And that's true. Sometimes that happens. But even the people that you meet in your congregation can be nasty, or you don't always like all the people you meet in the shops or in the synagogue or wherever you go, your neighbors, you don't always like them. The same with online. Now, I've also noticed there's a tendency for introverts to go onto dating sites and then think they're just going to observe people, but their problem, and they don't actually see this, is that the other people that also go to single sites are usually also introverts, because they struggle to relate and interact with people. So where your extroverts, they would go out and they get meet people, and then that's easier for them. Now we find it a lot of times in the chat rooms, and we have a lot of people in the chat room and nobody say anything, and then you get an extrovert that comes into the group and they start talking to people, and then they say, but nobody talks back. And that's a bit of a challenge, because that's how relationships are formed, is by talking about small stuff, the everyday nitty stuff. How's the weather? Where for an introvert, he thinks, oh, I can see the weather. Everybody knows it's warm, it's cold, or whatever the weather, or why should we talk about the weather? Let's talk about this other thing that I want to talk about. Maybe it's a scripture or whatever you want to talk about. And then they don't want to talk about that. They feel we can't connect nicely. So now the introvert, because they struggle with their communication skill or their relating style, is different, then they say, no, the website don't work, or the people that I meet at the synagogue is bad, or wherever I met the people, they are bad, because I'm struggling to have a relationship, instead of grasping, no, it's not the website, it's not the synagogue, it's not the other stuff. I'm an introvert and I have to learn how to relate to other people, because relationships don't exist. Relating does, and the better we get at relating, the better chances we have at the relationship. So I trust that help you clear up things for you, and post your comments and more questions that you have. I'll be happy to answer them. I don't know everything. I know some stuff, and what I know, I am willing to share with you, and I appreciate you. I appreciate how you comment and you like and you share and all that good stuff you do with us. I appreciate that. I enjoy having you on the site. I meet so many interesting people. And as a last word of encouragement, my basic or my default style is also introvert, and that's probably why I took so long to make a video with me in it. So just keep on, and there's hope. If it could happen to me, it can happen for you too. Shalom.